Hello and welcome back to a new video on the Cryptool 2 YouTube channel. In this video I want to show you how you can create and break an ADFGVX cipher. The ADFGVX is a cipher that was used during World War I. But before we start creating our own cipher and breaking it, I have a short introduction. First, I want to show you a short history of the ADFGVX. Then I want to give you some foundations about the cipher. And finally, we will do it in Cryptool 2. The ADFGX and ADFGVX are named after the used letters, which are A, D, F, G, V, and of course X. The ADFGX was first invented, and after that it was extended to the ADFGVX. Those letters were chosen since they were easy to use because they are quite different in the Morse alphabet. The ciphers were invented during World War I by German officer Fritz Niebel in 1918. The ADFGX was used for the first time on March 1, 1918 on the Western Front. The ADFGVX was used for the first time on June 1, 1918 on the Western and on the Eastern Front. Both ciphers were broken by the French officer Georges Pinvin in June 1918. So what is an ADFGX or an ADFGVX cipher? Both ciphers were the first fractionating ciphers. They consist of a first step, which is the substitution, and a second step, which is the transposition. I created a small example to show you how these ciphers work. The example is based on the ADFGVX. First, on the right side here, you see a so-called Polybius square. In a Polybius square, we have all the letters of the alphabet, and in this case also all 10 digits. On this side here, you have all the letters ADFGVX, and here is the same. And if you want to encrypt a letter, you search it in the square. For instance, we want to encrypt the Z here, and then we replace the Z with D and F. So let's have a look at the example here. We have the plain text hello. I marked all the letters in the plain text with different colors so that you can follow each letter during the encryption. So the first letter H is substituted, so we have a look at our square, we search for the letter H, and it's substituted by V and X. So we have V and X for the H. Then we have the E, and we also search in our square for the letter E, which is DV, so we substitute it by DV here. Then we do the same for the L. The L is DD, so we substitute it by DD. And we do it again because we have a second L. And finally we have the letter O, which is substituted by F and X. That's the first step, the substitution step. After the substitution step, we do the transposition step. The transposition is a columnar transposition cipher. We already had a video about this, so if you're interested in details about this, you can have a look at that video. And with the columnar transposition cipher, the text is written in a grid, and then the columns are read out. And as you can see here, the first column is VDF, XDX, this is here, then we have DD, and we have VD. And here you can see why the ADFGVX and the ADFGX are called fractionating ciphers. The original letter H is first substituted using two symbols, the V and the X, and in the end it is split or fractionated in the ciphertext. So what is the keyspace size of the ADFGVX cipher or the ADFGX cipher? To calculate the keyspace, we have to look at both used cipher types. First, the substitution keyspace. The substitution keyspace is for the ADFGX 25 factorial. This is because we have in the Polybius square 5 times 5 letters. That means we can only encrypt 25 letters, so the I and the J were used as the same letter. And with the ADFGVX, where we have 26 letters and 10 digits, we have 36 factorial possibilities or keys. The transposition is the second step, and its keyspace can be calculated by using the sum from I equals to 1 to n, where n is our maximum key length, and we take the factorial of n. And here on the bottom I have an example for an ADFGVX cipher where we use key length up to 15. So we calculate 36 factorial and multiply it with the sum from I of 1 to 15 n factorial, which is in the end 2 to the power of 178.44. So as you see, despite this is a manual and classical cipher, it has a really huge key space. Now let's do it in Crypto 2. We have two tasks. The first task is to create our own ADFGVX or ADFGX ciphers. And our second task, of course, is to break an ADFGVX ciphertext or multiple ciphertexts. I'm here now in Crypto 2 and I want to show you how you can create your own ADFGVX cipher. To do so, we first create an instance of the graphical editor, the workspace manager, by clicking on this icon here. Now we make a little more space by closing the locks because we don't need them. Then we search for ADF and we have the ADFGVX cipher here. We drag and drop the component on the workspace. Now, as usual, we need a text input for the key and for the text. So we have a text input for the plain text and we connect it here to the plain text. Then we have a text input for the substitution keyword. And we connect this. And we have the same for the transposition keyword. Then we need a text output for our ciphertext. And when you go in the settings tab of the ADFGVX component, you can also switch to ADFGX, and we also have an extended version of the cipher, the ADFGVXZ, but clearly this is not an historical cipher, this is something we invented for Crypto 2, but we stay on ADFGVX. Then we enter a text, we need a substitution keyword, and we need a transposition keyword. Now let's test if it works. As you can see, we get a text here, I make it a little bigger. So the ADFGVX component encrypted our text to an ADFGVX encrypted ciphertext. And as you can see here, we have about 47 characters here, and it roughly doubled to 76 characters. The ADFGVX component ignores the spaces in the text, so we have to remove the spaces. And then when you multiply the length of the plain text, you should get the length of the ciphertext here. Now let's try if we can also decrypt the ciphertext. To do so, I just copy the component, connect the output of the one component to the input of the other. I connect the substitution keyword to our substitution keyword input, and the same for the transposition. Then I copy this text output here. I copy using Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. And then I rename this to decrypted plain text. And of course we have to switch our component to decrypt. Now let's test it. And as we see here, we have a decrypted plain text. We have hello world. This is a test of the ADFGVX cipher. In the next step, I want to show you how you can actually break ADFGVX ciphertexts. I'm now back in the start center of Crypto 2. To break an ADFGVX cipher, I search for a template. I enter ADFGVX, and you see here ADFGVX heuristic analysis, which I open by double-clicking on it. Then I paste a ciphertext that I created for showing you how to break an ADFGVX cipher. It's an English plain text, which was encrypted using the ADFGVX. Now we have to change some parameters in the template. First of all, we have the ADFGVX analyzer here, and I change the key length to 13 because I know that I used a key length of 13. Clearly, if you don't know the key length, you have to test different key lengths and try it with 13, 14, 15, and so on. Then the language is of course not German, but English. Then after the ADFGVX analyzer analyzed the message, it will not output the final decrypted text, it will output the intermediate ciphertext, because all that the ADFGVX analyzer does is break the transposition cipher that was used. But after that, to actually break the complete cipher, we have to use the monoalphabetic substitution analyzer, because the second part of the ADFGVX is the monoalphabetic substitution. And when we want to decrypt it, we have to first reverse the transposition and then reverse the substitution. In that component, I change the setting to dictionary and genetic, and I change the language to English. When we start the analysis, the transposition will be first broken. After that, the substitution will be broken, and we will get the substitution key and the substitution alphabet, as well as the transposition key and some log information of the ADFGVX analyzer. So let's test it by just clicking on the play button. And as we can see here, the ADFGVX analyzer is running at about 10,000 keys per second, and it already found intermediate ciphertext with a quite good score, as you see here. And it already forwarded it to the substitution component here, and the substitution component already broke our message. We see here in Cryptography, the ADFGVX cipher was a field cipher used by the German, and so on. This was everything I wanted to show you in this short video. As you saw, it's quite easy to break ADFGVX ciphers in Crypto 2, but keep in mind that we used a very long message that was more than 1,000 letters, and if you want to break original ADFGVX messages, which are quite shorter, you cannot break just a single message, you have to use several messages, so-called in depth, to break all of these. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like the video, please give a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of these videos, hit the subscribe button and see you in the next video.